Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today we'll be looking at pictures that were made by the artist known as Hokusai. Hokusai lived from 1760 to 1849. About how long ago do you think that was? Give me a year. How about, give me a number. How about 200? This is the year 2020. If we go back 200 years, we'll be in the year 1820. Would that be during his lifetime? Yeah, so about 200 years ago. Hokusai lived in the town called Edo, which is now called Tokyo and is the capital of Japan. Japan is an Asian island nation. There's a mountain in Japan called Mount Fuji. It's a very famous landmark. Hokusai did many artworks featuring Mount Fuji. Let's look at a few of them and see if we can pick out any characteristics. How can we tell that it's Mount Fuji and not some other mountain? We can tell by its shape. It has a very distinct shape. We can tell by the fact that there's snow on top. Why do you think Hokusai made so many pictures of Mount Fuji? Well, let's think about it. He's making landscapes, and landscape is outdoor place, and it's an island nation, and it's like the biggest thing around there is Mount Fuji. So it's what we would call a landmark. If I'm an artist living in New York City, I might be making lots of pictures of the Empire State Building or the Statue of Liberty. If I'm an artist living in Paris, France, I might be making a lot of paintings of the Eiffel Tower because it's a big landmark and people will see it and recognize it. Some artists chose to make pictures of people from high society, and that's the way that it really was a lot of the time. Think about it this way. You didn't have any cameras, so there weren't pictures of people and things everywhere. It would only be somebody who could afford to pay an artist to either make a handmade picture of themselves or somebody else or a place, or to go buy one of those pictures from somebody that already owned it. Who could afford to do that? Probably the wealthiest people, like the kings, the queens, the rulers, and the people that had enough money to do that. Well, they wouldn't want to pay all that money for a picture of somebody else. So there weren't pictures of working class people often. Hokusai changed that. He wanted to make pictures of the working class because most people are of that class. There's only a few kings and queens, so he wanted to showcase everybody else. Throughout history, that was not common at that time. Hokusai did many small cartoon-like sketches that he called manga. This has now evolved into the very popular Japanese art style called anime. Surely you've seen anime before, but you probably didn't know that it was inspired by Hokusai. Hokusai sometimes painted and drew waves. How can we tell that it's a Hokusai wave? What are the characteristics that make it unique to a Hokusai drawing? The size is one thing. If I ever saw a wave that looked like this, I would be getting as far away from there as possible, as fast as possible, because that's a huge wave. Real water waves aren't usually that big. So they're kind of monstrous. They also look like they have claws. They look like monsters. They're very animated. There's lots of good movement in there in the lines that he would carve in that. You know a Hokusai wave when you see one. So if we were to look at a picture and try to decide if Hokusai made it or if he didn't, we would be looking to see if it looks like it was printed with certain ink colors. His ink colors are a bit faded. If they're too bright, we would know it's not Hokusai. If it looks painted, we would know that it's probably not Hokusai. We're looking for a printed image using those muted colors. We are also looking for some Japanese writing in it. In the top corner, he often has that. We might be looking for Japanese bridges or Japanese boats. We might be looking for waves, and we would be looking for working people. We may also be looking for Mount Fuji. Hokusai has inspired many artists since his time. Artists like Van Gogh, made their pictures look like Hokusai's in some ways, though Van Gogh was a painter. Other artists now make anime, which is derived, as we just learned, from his manga sketches. Hokusai was Japan's most famous printmaker. Printmaking is a long tradition. It involves not what you would think of printing something off of a computer, but rather it's like making a giant stamp out of wood. If you were to make what's called a woodcut, you would be carving lines into a block of wood. And then once you have it, it's like a big stamp, and you roll it up with ink, and then you push a piece of paper onto it. Anywhere that sticks up, the ink will stay and it will transfer like a stamp onto the paper. So you would have to make a different stamp for every color because you can only print like a flat color there. If you were to make a print of this image, you would need like 7 or 8 different plates to all stamp together and get them to line up. So there's a lot of skill involved in being a good printmaker. Hokusai was, of course, one of the best. So today I'm going to show you how to make a drawing that looks like this, using the sketchbook app on your iPad. You will open the sketchbook app first on your iPad, and you will tap the file menu at the top left corner of your screen. Then you'll tap New Sketch. Then you'll tap where it says Presets. Then you'll tap where it says Screen Resolution. Then you'll tap Create. It may ask you if you want to save what you had. If you liked the picture that was on your screen, make sure you save it. If you don't, just discard. Take 2 fingers and pinch them together on your screen to zoom out a bit. Now select a color. We want to go over to maybe in the yellows, and then we're going to take this slider, the circle that's inside that square, and we're going to drag that over a bit so that it's not so vibrant and bright. We're going to go over maybe a little bit to the left and a little bit up towards the top of the square where it's white. That's going to make the color more pale and more dull, like this. Then you're going to touch the paint bucket tool that's at the top of your screen. Tap anywhere inside the white page, and the white page becomes that tan color. Then tap the paint bucket tool to exit that tool. Now we're going to pick another color. Let's pick light blue this time. For this, we'll be using the fountain pen. We're going to start about halfway up on the left side here. We're going to end about halfway up on the right side, about there. In between, we will draw a line that curves up like this. It starts moving upwards, and then it gets to about halfway through the page, and it's up towards the top, and we stop. We skip a little space below that, and then we draw a line that curves down and then comes back up to where I said we would stop about halfway through on the right side. Now with a nice big size brush, you can start coloring this in. Keep filling that in until it's all solid blue. Then we're going to change colors to white. We're going to make our brush smaller now. Draw some short little white lines going along the top of the wave here, and when you reach the apex of the top of the wave, we're going to make those monster claw looking shapes. It looks like a backwards letter C. We repeat those over and over again along the top here so that they crash over like the top of a wave. Then we take white and we continue drawing along this line. On the right side of this, we draw these little white lines that just kind of go straight out to the right, and they trail off, getting smaller as they go. Then we can start there where we began the first time and curve way down, and then come back up to almost where we ended the first time. Then we're going to do the same thing with those little lines that trail off the edge. You can add a few lines here and there inside here, but just make sure you follow the direction of the wave. Let's draw a smaller wave in front of this one. We're going to start about halfway up to the top of the first wave on the left side. Keeps bumping the opacity. If that happens, just move that slider back up. So this will go up only about that high and then back down again. we can fill in the left and top sides with those little white marks again. You can also draw some lines coming down on the right side like we did before. All through the left side here, we're just going to fill in with little light lines. There's only one thing missing here. We're missing Mount Fuji. So with a small white brush way in the background, we're just going to draw the shape of Mount Fuji. If you don't get the shape right, that's okay. Just use the undo button. Add a little bit of white snow on top of the mountain, and the picture is finished. We're going to submit this to today's assignment. So go to the file menu in the top left corner of your screen. Tap where it says share. It's going to bring up this menu. Somewhere in here, there will be an option that says save image. Your icons may look slightly different than mine if you have a different software update on your iPad. It's okay. It's in there somewhere. We just need to find it. It says save image. Select that option and it will save this picture without the menus to your photos on your iPad. When you go into Schoology to make a submission, you'll be able to use that photo